Okay, hello everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today come to us release the new pads, and it is the long awaited balance pad. It took along 4 months I think for come to us to release the monster balancing and improvement. Okay, you can see this. The balance pad is all about the net 5 meta unit I think. Okay, I'm basically so happy with the nerf because I don't have this OP unit like Yeonhong. They get 1 plus cooldown. I'm happy so the Yeonhong cannot just back to back charge vitality, and it's nice. The cooldown become 4 turn. Charge vitality basically give you full attack bar, so it's only 3 time cooldown after the nerf. Before it's 2 cooldown, so it's good. 3 cooldown for charge vitality is good, because after he get skill up, the cooldown become 4 turn, and after 4 turn, if you use the skill yourself, get a 100 attack bar I think. So it's only 3 cooldown, and you cannot just file on proc to get charge vitality now. Okay, the Dragon Knight already is leaked I think the nerf. Before I think 2 weeks ago, some people already post it, their Ragdoll get a 50%. Then it happened. The Hathor now instead of AoE decrease 75% become reset the attack bar of the target enemy and decrease the rest by 30%. It's a good nerf I think for me, because I don't have Hathor yet. So Molong and Tianlang get nerf. Instead of 15% chance for 3 times dragon 3 time hit, it's only the 3rd hit remove beneficial and stun for 25%. So for 1 and 2 hit from the first and the second hit cannot strip and stun, but the 3rd hit stun. Xiongfei is still a nah I think. The Pandaver Mingyin, I think Mingyin got passive now. The inbuilt vampire for recover the HP by 30% during your turn, so defense don't count. Okay, Fairy King now Ganymede get really big nerf. He can strip and just seal magic you. He need a staple to walk. Before Gany Hathor can strip you and CC you, then now only Hathor that can strip you by the second skill, but second skill have 3 time cooldown I think. Now Ganymede cannot just skill 1 you and skill 3. That's nice, because I'm not a Gany user because I don't have one. Okay, Fairy King Daphnis single remove buff and all the same get 50%. I don't know, I don't happy with this because I have 3 Daphnis. I will show you, but I think it's not a game changing buff. You can see Edna can strip and stun and deal big damage. According to me, you trade 30% your HP with enemy 30%, then you know the multiplier in Hellfire is shit. Squall do better. Okay, Fairy King Dark, I don't know, it's a nice buff. I think Fairy King still stiff. Paladin Wind get buff. Justice Strike becomes 100% to decrease attack bar. Now come to us, why Opelia not here? Opelia is still shit. Threat State isn't better than Provoke. I know, Threat State cannot be resisted, but
you can skill, you can use skill 1, skill 2, skill 3. You can heal while provoked. You cannot use any skill except of skill 1, but you need required CC accuracy, ACC accuracy, accuracy resist check. But man, Opelia is a net 5. Give her a better skill. Now Paladin like is getting enough. You cannot recover the HP while you on Raven set. Before, I face many Paladin in LTA. When I hit her, he revenge me and heal the enemy. I think it's a bug, but I read it's not stat correctly in your turn, so she can heal in revenge. I think it's a good nerf because I had Paladin. I had Jhan facing her. Okay, Helwadi Water. I don't know. Destroy the enemy max HP the amount the max inflicted by the second attack. It's a buff for Helwadi third skill. Man, why? Where is Raki buff? Raki is still shit. Avaris more better than Raki. Okay, come to us a like shithole. He buffs shithole. Come to us always buffing shithole in every balance path. Now the second skill get buffed. Okay, Kumar the long waited. After Rakan buff, Kumar era is finished. But now you can slightly hope for Kumar be signed in LTA because the skill 1. Man, remove Venus special effect, 100% chance. It's a good. And skill 3 become silence. It's a good thing. Okay, now Triton get 2 turn silent. Dragon like Armageddon redistribute the HP of all allies. I think redistribute is like evenly match the HP of all allies, like balancing the HP. I don't know, like Brian. I think it's like Brian. Redistribute the HP of all allies and enemies, excluding the boss. I think it's a Brian second, third skill, evenly match. Then you match the HP, so you can get heal from the boss enemy HP or the enemy HP. Okay, Phoenix Wind Tempest. It doesn't matter, Tessar. You only use Tessar in farming for the farmer. And anyway, you use skill 3 and you clear the wave. So, what's the point for increasing attack bar after you can just nuke all the enemy and die? Shit, buff. Okay, Chiwu actually get buff. Chiwu actually deserve this buff. Because Soha, Aquila, is like Chiwu. Okay, just be honest, you use a stripper in your first turn or second turn. First turn Chiwu still have 100% HP, so why you recover the 5% HP when you are already in 100% state HP? It's a useless skill. But now they decrease its enemy attack bar by 15% per beneficial effect removed from its enemy. It's a good. So you can just run a Swift Chiwu, you get turn 1, you strip the benefit, you strip Willoon, or you strip Busa buff, and you can decrease the attack bar by 30%. And maybe its activation rate is 100% and it's good. Okay, Polar Queen Water, I don't know why they buff Alicia. Alicia is already good, but after this, Alicia become more good. If you cannot kill the enemy, you can freeze them. Okay, Pirate Captain Fire. I don't use it, but after you detonate, you can get a turn and you can use second skill for AoE stun. Okay, Platy got buff. Third turn stun, I don't know if it's good. And this Mermaid Water reduce the become as except in ability gain on and it become a passive skill, but it's not more better than Raccoon is skill. Raccoon is still better, I think. Vampire Fire I like. Now you can skill up your Feather Heal for the max because you get the second hit from the second skill. Vampire Water, I don't know if it's good for Liesel. Okay, Cobalt Bomber Fire, AoE Detonate, but it's a random skill, Bomb Detonate, still not reliable, but better than before because you can use this in Guild Seek. In CG, you can use this for detonated your bomber team. Okay, and then when Delpoy get above 30% heal, is nice. They buff Arnold. Okay, the rest, I don't know. Team Champion, you can read it. Okay, the most important skill is in the top. Yun Hong, Ragdoll, Hatter, Gap, and Molong. Okay, hope you enjoyed my review. If you before that, you can just see it. Here, I got 3 Deafness. This one, you can see 1 Deafness. Where is my 2 other Deafness? And where's the 3rd Deafness? 3rd. I'm so sad. But yeah, okay. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoy. See you in my next Summoner War video.